Somebody, God bless you, everyone watching me out there. It's good to see you once again to share the word of God with you. I bless God for who He is. I thank God for the privilege He has given me to stand here today to minister His word in Jesus' name. Lord, I give you all the praise for this moment. Lord, as I speak your word, Lord, speak through me. Let the power of the Holy Spirit take preeminent control. Let your word flow through me, O God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father, as I speak your word. Lord, touch the heart of your people, as many that need this word out there. Let them be touched, let them be transformed. Let them, this word help them recognize who you are. Let them know your greatness. Let them know that you are God and none to be compared with you, O God. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Today I'm going to be talking about a topic I titled, Serving God in Truth. By the grace of God, my name is Pastor Mrs. Precious Sylvester Osayende Unieze. Amen. Today, our text will be taken from John 4, 23 to 24. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Serving God in truth. Amen. See, there's nothing like truth. There's nothing like truth when we live and walk in truth. There is nothing like truth. The Bible says, and ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Praise the Lord. So whatever we are doing is good, and we should learn to be truthful, no matter how difficult it is. Because the truth is what sets people free. Hallelujah. It's good to be straightforward. Be straightforward. Be direct in whatever you are doing. Because no matter how you hide, a day will come that the truth will surely come out, and you know you are not going to be happy when you see that your fake life or the lies that you told is hard. So it's better to just be yourself, be truthful. And actually, as a Christian, if you really know that you fear God and you love God, you like to walk in truth. You want to serve God in truth. You know the Bible says God is Jehovah Elohi, the God who sees. No matter how we try to hide whatever we do, He sees us. Whatever we do in the secret, in public, He sees us. So it doesn't matter. It's not just because God is seeing us, but it's good that we should live a truthful life. It pleases God to see us live a truthful life as a child of God. So, it shouldn't look like because God is watching you, you want to be truthful. Let it be that because you are a child of God, because you love God, and you fear God, so I want to live a truthful life. I don't want to live in lies. I don't want to be in the flesh. I don't want to walk or live under the influence of the devil himself. I want to serve God. I'm a child of God. I want to live and obey the word of God. And the word of God is truth. There is no lie in the word of God. The only thing God cannot do is to lie. Whatever He says, He will do. Hallelujah. So we should learn to live like that, living in the truth. Hallelujah. Because no matter what we do, God is watching. And when we serve God in truth, it makes our Christian life easier for us. And we serve God happily. You enjoy serving God, because when you are living in truth, you are obeying the word of God, you know that you being a Christian, you are sincere and you are truthful in your ways with God, whether in the secret or in the public, God is watching you. Anybody that obeys the word of God, God's presence always abides with such people. That is just the truth about it. Amen. So when God sees the way you carry his matter in his heart, when God knows that sin is not anywhere around your territory, it's not in your heart. You know, people just say it was the handwork of the devil. If you didn't open your heart for the devil to creep in, the devil will not use you as an instrument. Amen. So it's good we talk to ourselves and say, my body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. So the temple of the Holy Spirit, we never and can never accommodate every element of sin. Praise the Lord. What's supposed to be in our body, in our hearts, is the word of God. And when you have the word of God inside you, you will not, there will be no space for those negative thoughts, those elements of sin. Because you have made up your life to serve God in spirit and in truth. Hallelujah. So let's go to the book of John 4. John chapter 4, verse 23 to 24. Amen. He said, but the hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshippers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship him. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. God is an omnipresent God. No matter how we hide our attitude, our character, or no matter how we hide whatever we do, God is everywhere. He's watching us. And the Bible says we all are going to give account of the way we live our life. Yeah. And the planet Earth. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So, we should know that God is God, and we should learn to obey his commandment. Because when we live in sin, when we try to be who we are not outside, and we go in there to kneel down and pray and shed tears, God is not there. Because the Bible says, he said, the prayer of a sinner is an abomination in the sight of God. It is just a waste of time. Let's serve God in spirit and in truth. Even one thing some people don't know. If you live your life in truth, so we are not perfect. People have their own weaknesses. But by the time you don't hide it, that is when you will know how to correct it. But by the time you try to fake it, trying to say or do what you are not, you are just pampering those sins. You are magnifying those sins and it just keep growing. But by the time you just learn to be truthful to yourself, you just face life the way it is. That is when you now start seeing your weakness. That is when you now know how you will correct it. Praise the Lord. God is the Spirit. He seeth all. Amen. He seeth our heart. David is a very good example. David, the Bible said God, David is a man after God's own heart. Praise the Lord. That was why we saw David. David, when even when he sinned, when he slept with Bathsheba, the mother of Solomon, praise the Lord, and God still forgave him, the 12 tribe of Judah would have been taken away from David. But because God loved David, because God sees how David have his matter in his heart, one tribe was still given to David. Praise the Lord. So, if God see the way we care about his work, if God see how we carry his matter in our heart, if God sees our obedience, the way we obey him, whether in secret or in public, it also moves the hand of God to be at work in our life. That is just the truth about this whole thing. We cannot lie to God because he sees us. It might not be easy to change from those attitudes, but just start from somewhere. Start from somewhere, and God will help you. I keep telling people, don't say, how do I stop? Tell God, give me the grace. Father God, I need the grace. I want to stop this thing. It will help you. When you see that the situation is too tough for you, that is when you need to go to a man of God that has a higher anointing to pray for you. First of all, are you even ready to quit that attitude? Are you ready to quit that which does not give God glory that you have been doing? Make up your mind. Make up your mind to be a true child of God. Make up your mind to serve God in spirit and in truth. You that is not in the Lord, yeah, make up your mind to give your life to God, because serving God is peace. It's only in God that you will find peace that no man, nothing can give you in this planet Earth. Make up your mind to serve God, to follow God and God alone, not one leg in the church, one leg out. No, just God alone. You will see the manifestation of the work of God in your life. God said he's a jealous God. So you cannot serve God and also serve the devil. It doesn't work that way. I see people come to their pastor for pastor to pray for them. The pastor will fast and pray. At the end, because they have doubting Thomas, they are the doubting Thomas type, you will see them go behind the pastor to one Baba or to one spiritualist, spending the money that they cannot spend for the church for them to solve their problem. You have wasted your money. Hallelujah. Money is not easy to get. You take your hard-earned money to give to someone, a human being like you, that is even using diabolical powers. It's going to add to your problem. Serve God in truth. When you serve God in truth, these things are easy. Stop giving your pastors too much work. The pastors will fast and pray and pray. Later, some of them will say, this pastor, he doesn't carry the power of God. But they know what they are doing. Let me tell you, there is nothing that the devil will give to you that is free. When he gives you one, he's coming to collect 10. That is just the truth about it. Whatever God gives to you, you will have peace. You receive it in peace. Whatever the devil gives to you, watch your back, because it's coming to collect. If it is one, it's going to collect 10 from you. Praise the Lord. So learn to serve God in truth. In your doing, in your attitude, learn to serve God in truth. Another thing I've noticed in the churches today, what do we do when we leave the church? We come to God, we clap our hands, we dance like never before. When we leave the presence of God, what do we do at home in our secrets? What do we say? How do we talk about the message in the church? How do we talk about our pastors? Actually, some people come to the church to see the mistake a pastor will make, to see the mistake a brother or a sister will make, to see the clothes that people put on. Why are you in the church? Praise the Lord. When do you do, what do you do after Sunday service? When you get home, what do you do? What kind of life do you live? Sometimes I hear people sing. I hear people pray when they come to church. Sometimes I ask myself. I know we just need to grow from level to level. But you cannot tell me you have been in the church, you have been coming every day to every service, you have been in the church for the past 5 years. You are still the same, you are not growing. Talk to yourself. What do you do when you get home? When you drop your Bible at home, what do you do? How do you live your life? It's a question that we need to ask ourselves. Some people will come to church, they pray, they look dried. An unbeliever will even pray. You will know that somebody is praying, even more than somebody that has been in the church for years. We should learn to talk to ourselves. There are questions we need to ask ourselves. Praise the Lord. Don't you know, as a child of God, when you really live a holy life, you have a truthful relationship with God. There are situations that will come. You don't even need to bother your pastor to come and pray for you. Because some people, even if a mosquito bites them, they will call their pastor. If you live a holy life, there are situations you can handle by yourself. It is when issues get out of hand, you run to your pastor. Because I can't imagine this one dragged the pastor here, the other one dragged the pastor here. When is the pastor, how is he going to breathe? He's a human being, just made God called him and he made himself available. Praise the Lord. Why am I saying all these things? If we really live a truthful life, the way we live outside is the way we live inside in our private lives, we will really know that we are serving God. And the hand of God will be at work in our life. And whenever we call God, he will answer. When it is the time of God, he answers. Praise the Lord. So living a holy, serving God in truth is very important. Praise the Lord. Anyone that is used to disobeying the word of God does not know who God is. And such people is like they don't appreciate what God did for them. They don't appreciate what Jesus did for them in the cross of Calvary. Praise the Lord. And if you are really born again, you will not take pleasure in disobeying God. Some people, they say they are Christians. They live a life that they don't care about what they do. They just feel so relaxed when they disobey God. When they hurt human beings like this, they feel that nothing is happening. If you are really born again, you won't take pleasure in doing such things. Hallelujah. If the fear of God is there, you don't need somebody to tell you. If you know you love God, you fear God, you don't need somebody to tell you that what you are doing is wrong, because the Spirit of God lives inside of you. Hallelujah. That is a proof that you are a child of God, not just saying, I'm a born-again Christian. I'm a born-again Christian, it shows by your attitude, by the way you talk, the way you dress, the way you do things. You know, when you're in the midst of people, before you tell them I'm a Christian, the way you talk, your appearance, first of all, speak for you. Haven't you met with people that when you say I'm a Christian, I fellowship in so and so church, they'll say, yes, I said it. I said it, that there is something about you, because they have seen you, the way you talk, your appearance, your attitude. We should learn to walk on our attitude as children of God. It's very important. We shouldn't be living this I don't care life. Praise the Lord. We should learn. There are things we don't, it's not some of us do this thing. It's not that we just did it intentionally. We just feel that it doesn't matter. There are things that matter. Hallelujah. Discipline should be applied as a child of God. Don't do as the unbelievers do. Some unbelievers that I see, they even have good attitude, more than people that call themselves Christian. We should learn to work on ourselves. The Bible says, we are the light of the world. Let people see us I want to be like us. Our life, our attitude, our ways of life should be what bring people into the kingdom of God, not the other way around. Hallelujah. God is a good God, and there is none to be compared with him. So, the only way we can appreciate what God has done for us is by obeying the word of God, praising him, giving him thanks, not on the contrary. Because God, he owns everything. God just needs our obedience. Praise the Lord. So, our obeying God shouldn't be in the flesh. We should learn to obey God in everything we do, both in the secret and in the public. That is the proof that we are serving God in truth. Hallelujah. We should know that God is God, whether in the good time or in the bad time. Sometimes things can be happening and it looks like God is silent. I always use this word. He's not silent. He's walking behind the scene. Don't say because of that situation you want to switch and quickly do this because God, I have to sort myself out. You should be very careful because sometimes when you take this step, you find out that, oh, nobody saw me. You want to take the second step. Just like that, before you know what is happening, you have completely backslided. Hallelujah. I'm not trying to judge anyone, but what I'm trying to say is that when we serve God in spirit and in truth, it makes God to hear us fast. It makes things to work well for us as a child of God. When we obey God and we serve him in spirit and in truth, we will see the hand of God in whatever we do. God's presence will be seen in your life. Anywhere you go, people will know that this is the child of God. Don't live a kind of life that people will be asking, I thought she or he said is a Christian, but where is the God inside? Because some prayers are not answered because the ways of some people are not right with God. So we should learn to talk to ourselves and amend our way. We should examine ourselves. It's for our own good. Because actually, when we disobey God, we are trying to tell God we are ungrateful. We don't know who he is. Because if you know who your father is, a child that knows what his father will do to him when he returns from work, we'll be afraid to disobey his father. So when you disobey God, your heavenly father, you don't know who he is. That is just the truth. It's just very simple. Hallelujah. So I'm going to stop here for today by the grace of God. I pray this message bless someone today in the name of Jesus. And I leave you in the presence of God. And once again, my name is Pastor Mrs. Precious Sylvester Osayende Onyeze. By the grace of God, I will see you in my next video. God bless you.